up the left side. Yandel sent it for Bama. Cuts it. Oh! And he missed it high. Not sure if Quick got a piece of that. But Jonathan Quick, as he always does, came out to challenge the dangerous Radim Bravada.
Bravada missed the net in game four from the slot. Here, on a perfect 3-on-2, he tries to go high to the glove side. Whitney goes to one side. Yandel pulls up. The weak side player is Bravada. And this one just goes over the net. Yep. Oh, what a classic two-pad slide attempt anyway by the athletic Quick.
Yeah, that was just a plain old miss there by Bravada. He had some clean-cut chances in game four. He hasn't had any points in the last seven games. Just not feeling it yet.
A guy that scored 35 goals in the regular season. Second highest point getter behind Ray Whitney on this team that basically does it by committee.
And the problem, how that play started was Mike Richards made a real bad pass out of the corner in the middle of the ice for the turnover and caught all three of the LA forwards.
Trevor Lewis kicks it ahead. Now Jared Stoll has checked it.
More and more. So you don't want to go in there and be the one called. But let's go back to this chance again and keep your eye on the toe. You know, on second look, Brian, I think that went off the left toe of Jonathan Quick. There.
Oh, yes.
And you see the way it
changed
turns?
Direction.
You know, it's coming up there. It's flat. Now
he
it
did.
Turns.
He had it under the bar.
Oh, my goodness.
Also, looking at that panger, you're surprised maybe he didn't fake the shot and just go to that quick backhand because he loves that move on the shootouts and breakaways.
Yeah, he had a spot kick, though, and he's got a big curve on that stick. He likes to go high. Obviously had his mind set up, but, boy, Rogie Vachon would have been proud of that two-pad stacker there.
Dustin Brown shot is blocked, and back the other way now. The Coyotes could have an odd man.